Hey guys, this is Faye from Feisworld Media. In this video, I'm going to show you how to design lower third designs using Canva for your live stream. In fact, you can use the link in the description below to download all these templates for just $10, a one-time fee, or just follow along. I'll show you exactly how I'm able to create them. Imagine you're an author, you're able to use your name, your book cover, and create a lower third design such as this. Or you want to show people step-by-step process as you're streaming. Step one, step two, step three, just like that, easy. You can also adapt to your own brand colors. Now, if you're a podcaster, you're able to use lower third designs just like this, or like this. You can also have something like this, or like this, or all around the border, just like this. Let's get started. In this part of the tutorial, I'm going to show you different types of lower thirds overlay that you can consider. Now, one thing to mention is the reason it's called lower third is because it's so versatile. You know, it's not going to cover your face. You can still speak over it. So what I'm using here is called Canva. Now, if you don't have Canva or you only have the basic version, you will need to upgrade to the professional one so that you can download whatever you design with a transparent background. So let me show you an example. This is an image with a transparent background. So the beige color in the back, it's actually transparent, and only the elements in color are the ones that are going to show up on the screen. And in order to do that, you will need the pro version of Canva. The good news is that it's still very affordable. On canva.com/pricing, you will notice that for the pro version, if you toggle this little button to the left to bill monthly, it is $12.95. One could argue that you sign up for 1 month, and once you create all the things you need, you can always discontinue that. Now let's come back to this element here. For all the designs we'll be talking today, we'll be using the same orientation or dimension. When you come into Canva, go to upper right-hand corner, click on Create a Design. You can choose a custom size, but here we're going to make it really easy and it's exact same size as YouTube thumbnail, 1280 by 720. The good news is within Canva, you can scale up and scale down. So just like that, and this will give you that perfect 16 by 9 dimension. With that said, let's get started recreating the first one, which is what I called a step lower third banner. So I'm going to simply copy and paste that, but I'm going to just start from scratch. You're going to click elements on the left-hand side, and we're going to use shapes a lot. In our case, we're going to use this looks like a square, but you can really resize it to whatever element you need it to be. So I'm going to just make it into a rectangle here, pin it to the lower left-hand corner. I'm going to simply drag the other side of this rectangle. What I like about Canva is that you see it snaps right onto the edge, so you don't have to guess or measure very carefully. So you can make this any color you want. Now, you do want a second element. So to do that, I can simply just copy and paste the element. And I want this one to be, for example, white, just like the one above. I'm going to use the color green because that may be your brand color, and I want to show you something slightly different. Now, I want the second element here to be white. Now I have two rectangles kind of overlapping each other. And as you can see right above it, you can introduce a little element here. It can be your photo, it can be your logo, whatever it may be. Now look to the element section on the left and simply choose frames. So for a frame, I'm going to use the simplest circle one. I can resize it and to a size I like. If it's a little bit big, I can resize it to be even smaller. And now I can grab this element and look what happens. You see this dotted line here? The dotted red line shows me that it's centered in between these two rectangles. That's perfect. And if you want to upload your logo, simply click on this upload button here and upload media. It can be a photo, it can be a logo, and I'm just going to use a photo I previously uploaded here. And if you want to adjust the size of the photo, for example, where your face is centered, all you have to do is double click on it and just move it around as you need to. That's it. Let's add some text element here. So we can add a text element using the text element here on the left-hand side. Click on text and we have heading, subheading, and a little bit of body text. So they're just different in size, but you can always change them as well as the font of your choice. So I'm going to click on the middle one, add a subheading. The moment I click on that, as you can see, there's a placeholder text here. I'm just going to grab it with my pointer, with my cursor, and I can type in step one. Now, if this is too far away from the left-hand side, I can just move it in here and I can say, this is step one of doing something. Now, what's happening here, as you can see, is now it's resizing and it's wrapping the text around the width of the box. Whenever you see this little line here, that means you can adjust the width of the box again. So you can just eyeball this, or another way to do this is, you know, before it wraps up just like that, now you're going to drag this box because this is the width of what you need. Put it here. Now we're going to align the text a little bit differently. Look up right here. This is where you can change the alignment. So I want this to align to the left-hand side so that when I copy and paste this again, look, now I can really stack up. See this dotted pink line again. It's aligning these two right here. So, presented by Fei Wu. You really can make these lower thirds text whatever you want it to be. And if you think black text is a little bit too daunting, you can change the text color here up above into white. So it's a little bit softer and it looks a little bit more put together. Now, if you want this presented by Fei a little bit smaller, highlight, simply select the text box and drag the lower right hand any corner of the text box here. I love this feature by Canva, and just resize it to what you want. One thing to clarify and to help you guys out is that Canva is a very, very powerful tool. So everything I'm showing you, there are many variations to do that. For example, if you want to use a fancy frame or a frame that's not a perfect circle, what you can do is, I'm going to copy this to show you guys, simply remove this element, including this frame itself, and go to the left-hand side, inside elements, you will see this whole section called frames. You can click on see all next to frame, and then you can scroll down. There's a variety of everything here. For example, that's iPad, and then you can use a computer or a laptop. There's just so much going on. You can use a frame. One of the ones that I like to use is this one right here, because it has like a little colored circle right outside of it. So you can drop this in just like what we did a moment ago. And while you're here, you can see that you can even change this color of this outline. For example, change it to orange or change it to white or even something drastic like a red, and then come back to upload and you can drag the same photo here too. So there you go. You can get really sophisticated and detail oriented if you choose to. But then again, if this is the first time for you to try this, I would say definitely get it done before you get too creative and spend too much time creating something, because at the end of the day, you know, sometimes your audience won't care about this lower third or any overlay as much as you do. With that said, let's take a look at another example down here, which is how to create an author's book and an author's name. You probably guessed it right. It's exactly what we did. The difference here is now I'm using a book as opposed to a photo. Now, all you have to do, guys, it's super simple. With this book cover removed, so you can use a 2D version, and this is what it will look like. So actually not so bad either. Again, whatever element you drag in, you can just touch up and grab the corner, any corner really, as you can see, and just resize it to your liking. So not bad. Personally, I do like the 3D version. It's a little bit more vibrant. I love the little corner, little shadow here. And that's it. By the way, if you are using this approach, I would recommend that you always consider giving this name here, Michael Lecky, a background, whatever it is. So what you want to do again is use this box and then copy it, move it up, and then change this into white. And then you may be thinking, oh, it's covering everything. So now upper right hand corner, you can change the position here and just keep sending it to the back like this. And now personally, I want this, you know, you can resize this white section here to be up here. And the reason why I think this is important is because, once again, You know, you want to make sure that the lower third has some sort of background, because let's say if you don't have a background or white background here, right, what's going to happen is if that day you happen to wear a black shirt, and this black text is going to get lost over your black shirt as a background. If you want something a little bit more elegant than just a long white bar, what we can do is you can select this bar right here and just reduce the size of it. So what I mean by that is I slide over and I move this white bar here to be right around here so that this part will be transparent. So let me prove this to you. I'm going to download. Whenever you're ready, download your asset, go to download and choose PNG. It's already suggested in default one. Then choose transparent background. Then within Canva, you can see page 7 and you're going to select page 7 from the list. And then click on done. One more time, click on download. So let me just pop open right here. You see, this is what I'm talking about. I'm not trying to manipulate this or make every corner or pixel perfect, but there you have it. You have this white background. So if that day, you know, the lighting is not good, if you're wearing a black shirt or t-shirt, you can be sure that your name is still shown. Lastly, these are the variations. Again, this is my podcast. And this is my cover art. If you think that there isn't enough definition, if you want something behind the cover art, just to give you that little bit elegant kind of outline approach, all you have to do is so simple. I'm gonna show it on this example right here. So I'm gonna go to elements on the left-hand side again. And if you have frames pre-selected, don't get confused, just clear it out by either, you know, backspace into it or use this cross sign. And that's gonna bring you back to the sort of the landing section or all the elements. So choose again this little square by default. The color is red, but you can change it to any other color. I'm gonna use a blue color, probably not gonna look very good. And then just drop it slightly. You can even drop right above my cover art here and you can resize it a little bit. Now it's covering it, but again, we just talked about this a moment ago. You can change the position to backward. There you have it. So it looks ugly, right? But what you can do is you can resize it like this. I even use the up and down, left and right arrow on my keyboard because it's gonna give me that refinement I really love. I'm not recommending blue goes well with this. I'm simply showing you a different example. Now, the last thing I wanna say is, hey, what about all those cute icons, emojis? You bet that Canva has loads of them. So to show you where they are, for example, the YouTube, Facebook, again, is under element. So here in the search elements pro search bar, you can search for YouTube. And once you select YouTube, click on that, and it drops this little icon in right away. And guess what? I love this magic recommendation. What it means is it recognizes that you're trying to select social media icons, and now it just listed all the other ones that you might need. And you can even click on see all to see more of them. I mean, I'm personally not on all of them myself. And what I recommend is when you line up these icons, trying to select similar designs, meaning whether you select all the circle ones, if they exist, or select all the sort of square or rounded, square, rounded, corner square ones, so they look a little bit more consistent. Now, you may be wondering, how did you line up all of these icons? First of all, remember that in the link is in the description below, so you can download all the templates I'm showing to you right now, and you can simply swap out my cover art with your cover art, and you don't have to re-line up these icons. But I'm gonna show you how I did it. First of all, I'm just gonna select a whole bunch of random icons, like that. And they're coming in at different sizes, which is a little annoying because what happens is Canva remembers the last time I used an icon. It will introduce them as the same size, as you can see, but I never really used TikTok. So let's do this. I'm gonna first of all resize TikTok. It's way too big, but how do I know that it's actually the same size as these? A couple of ways to do that. You can either overlay them, that's pretty close, right? Or you can drag the corner. Whenever you see this dotted pink line, you know that it's about the same size as the other two. Now let's just play, for example, these are the three icons that you need. And now they're different distance, right? You're not even sure if they're lined up the same way. Once you select the three elements, first of all, you can move them anywhere you want on this screen, right? Then you select position. There are two sections. One is called align elements. The other is space evenly. So if you want them to align in the middle like this, and these icons are really helpful, click on middle. You see all of a sudden they're lined up right in the middle there. And then I say, I want to make sure that they're horizontally spaced evenly, but it's grayed out because they're already spaced evenly. I'm gonna change that just so you see the difference. If these three elements are not horizontally aligned evenly, now I go to position and I do this, choose right here. You see that, so Twitter, the Twitter icon just bounced right into the middle. But from here, if you want them to be a lot closer, you can do this too. And look, once again, it's gonna space them just like that. You can do this with as many elements as you want. You can line up 20 icons if you choose to. So that's definitely a little trick I wanna show you guys. And all these elements are right there. Again, under elements, you can play around so much. And it's not just about social media icons, but you can also do things like smile, and here are all your smiley faces. And you can type in things like, I don't know, a bank. And here are all the little bank icons. And you can also use, let's see what's happening with COVID. There is a lot of COVID talk, masks. So definitely play around and best of luck, guys. This tutorial is definitely a little bit longer, but I want to show you guys what it takes to create some of these. And if you don't want to do any of this on your own, make sure you know that it's in the description below. And I charge only $10 for everything you've seen today. And it's a one-time fee. You do not have to pay for it again. So avoid any subscriptions. This is the way to go. Thank you so much for watching. This is Faye and this is Feisworld Media. I'm so glad you're here and I cannot wait to bring even more better, awesomer content related to design, live stream, Zoom, and building your business in the near future. See you next time.